Hi everybody, so part two of our Q&A session, so I'm going to jump straight into the questions now. So we've got five remaining questions we're going to take you through. So the first question is, do you get a closed rail on the Grand California? This is a big yes and a big no. So if you get a California Grand 600, which has the open wardrobe, I'll show you a picture now, you get a closed rail in there. And if you get the 680, which has a closed wardrobe, because you have a door on there, which is on there as well, is you don't get a closed rail. Why? I do not know. Do not know the answer to that at all. Obviously, I'm sure that you could fit something that was in the 680 as far as a rail is concerned. It is something I have mentioned with Volkswagen Brand about this before, but I've not had anything back on that. So obviously, if I do, I'll let you know. But so yes in one, no in the other. But I'm sure you can probably, there's lots of things we could fit to get a closed rail, even ones that just stick onto the side. You've probably seen them that expand on both sides, and then you can put them where you would want it to be. And that might be the reason why there isn't one in the Grand itself on the 680, because it would allow you even possibly to put two rails in there if you had certain things you wanted to put in, because it's quite a deep and long cupboard that's there. Next question is regarding the Ocean Coast, and it's talking about the sports package. So does the sports package come with lower suspension? And I think the reason they've asked for that is because it says addition alloy wheel includes suspension range 264 on configurator. It doesn't have a lowered suspension or anything like that with the sports pack. It's just got the standard suspension setup that's on there. You've got the bigger 18-inch Springfield wheels which come with that. And the extra bit that it's talking about there is probably something to do with the factory. And it might be that it has got a slight tweak to the suspension, but the actual ride height of the suspension, as far as I'm aware, is not changed at all. And it definitely hasn't got a lowering kit or anything like that installed on it. One of you has asked about the bed upstairs in the Grand California in relation to the Ocean as well. So we've mentioned a few times about weight limits on the actual Ocean variation here, and it's about 150 kg or 75 kg per person, but obviously it will take a lot heavier than that, but obviously there is a number which is attached to it. And they're asking about the Grand California, because obviously this is designed for adults. Is the weight limit any reduced on the one upstairs? So when I mentioned that it's designed for children, or designed for younger people in the bed upstairs in the Grand California, that's more to do with the actual length of it, because obviously one side is longer with the flap over which is on there, and the other side is obviously a lot shorter, and it's more designed for children because of the actual size of it, who'd actually better lie down in there rather than an actual weight issue which comes with it as well. So I have asked the question what the weight differences are that's on there, but obviously because it is only designed for children, from a weight perspective on there, there wouldn't be any issues with the weight. Next question is, we've heard some rumours that the Grand California factory is shut, and if it was true, how would this affect lead times? So we did a factory update not long ago, and I think I mentioned in there that all the factories have been shut. And this was to do with semi-component issues that they were missing. So all the factories were shut. The Grand California factory, the Crafter factory, had shut down as well for a short period of time. Obviously, those things did affect the builds on there, because for that period of time, if you imagine if there's X number of vehicles that are booked in for a week that the factory was shut down, they obviously then have to be rescheduled back into the production of where we're going. But a good side of it is with the Grand California, the lead times are a lot less than what they are for the Ocean and Coast. So as far as the difference is concerned, it's not really made much difference to the lead time on those. And even for the California Ocean and Coast, I mean, I gave you this in the update, we've been giving people longer lead times. I've been telling you there's a longer lead time anyway, so there's a bit of room for movement in those as well, so it's not something really I don't think that would affect the builds of your vehicles coming out. Obviously, if you had one that was just in the factory before that shutdown, obviously then that will be delayed a bit coming out at the other end as well. So there could be a bit of a delay there, but I don't think it's anything of significance compared to the bigger picture of delays, of which unfortunately we have had. And finally, last question is to do with additional two-year warranty. So we've asked, I understand that there's an additional two-year warranty can be purchased within the first 90 days of a new van purchase. Is that correct? And if so, what's the cost? So that applies to all Volkswagen commercial vehicles, so you can extend the warranty in the first 3 months, or 90 days exactly as it's published, it's in there, from when you purchase it, from when its registration date is. And that's to extend the warranty either to 4 years or to 5 years. Now, I know there'll be a lot of you who maybe have bought Californias now, and you'll have the care package, for example, that's with it, which was a four-year extension, additional years extension that's on there. But lots of people, that's now been removed from the vehicles on the ocean and coast models and things like that. Or you may have bought one previous to that and earlier than those on there. But the extended warranty, I think, is really, really good value for money. Pretty much the one that we do most of the time, so the one that most people extend to, is the 5 years or 80,000 miles. You can do it for 4 years, which is what you used to get in the care package, with a higher mileage, 150,000 miles. But for most people, the five-year one is the most cost-effective one if you're buying it straight off the shelf that's on there. So on Transporters and on Crafter, the cost of that is £478.80. So that's basically £399 plus the VAT that's on there, and that will extend it for the 5 years. 80,000 miles, and that's what I would recommend if you're buying one that wasn't covered by any form of care package that you've had in the past, depending on when you ordered it. And I think that represents really good value for money. That's just under £500 for 2 years, so £250 per year. And I said you've got one claim maybe in each of those years, and that warranty, that additional warranty, is paid for itself, and it does give you a lot of peace of mind that's with it as well. Obviously, talking about warranties as well, you may have seen the video we did on all-in-one from Volkswagen. Again, we'll put a link up for that as well. So depending on the age of your California, for example, if you're outside of that time period, once you get towards the end of your three-year manufacturer standard warranty that's with the vehicle, check out that video, have a look at those. They're doing really well. There's lots of people interested in the all-in-one. Great product. Check the video out. I'm sure you'll get the enthusiasm for it. I think it's a really, really good offer from Volkswagen that they've put out there as well. So that's all the questions. We've been through everything there for the questions on the latest Q&A session. We'll be doing another Q&A session in about a month's time. So if there's anything that you've thought of today, pop in those comments box below. We've always said to you, we try and do our best to do questions and answers all in the Q&A session so that everybody gets to hear those questions as well. And there's no bad questions, because if you've got a question, there's a good chance somebody out there has got the same question, may not have answered it. So keep those questions coming. It's great. I like doing the Q&A sessions as well. If I don't know, and there is sometimes I'm not sure about something, I'll go and find out. That's our basis. And then, you know, if we've not included it in this Q&A session, for example, it might be because I'm waiting for the information to come back so we can then put it in the next Q&A session. So we'll always try and get there and get those answers to you and give you as much up-to-date knowledge as we can. So thanks for watching today. Hope you enjoyed it. I hope that's given you a bit more information on some questions and comments that you've had. If you don't subscribe, please subscribe. It really does help the channel out. And we'll see you next time.